Hello golfers, PGA teaching professional Todd Cope, Director of Instruction for the Todd Cope Golf Academy. And on behalf of my good friends at Swing Caddy, I want to first of all thank you for your purchase of the SC200 and let you know from my own personal experience of somebody who utilizes this product on a daily basis that in your hands right now, you have something that's going to definitely help you play better golf. So what I want to do is help you understand how to get the most out of your SC200. So the first thing I'm going to talk about is what's actually in the box. What are the contents in the box that you have in your hands right now? So let's take a few moments and go through what's actually in the box. So I've got it right here. So the first thing I'm going to do is just going to go ahead and take it out of its sleeve and I'm going to go ahead and open it up. Now inside the box here, there's going to be actually four different things. The first thing that you're going to see is the user manual. Obviously some great information in there that can answer a lot of your questions. Also, a nice little card here that says the SC200 tips for users, some also wonderful information to help us understand how to use it. Most importantly now, the two main things in here are gonna be the remote control, which we're gonna talk a lot about, how to utilize that, and the actual SC200 unit itself. Now, I also wanna make a special note that there's a nice protective film cover on it that you can peel off once we get ready to use it. Now we're going to talk about how to set the actual unit up. So as I previously mentioned, the first thing you're going to do is to remove the protective film from the front of the unit. The next step is going to be to place four AAA batteries in the back of the unit. Now the power button is located on the top right-hand corner of your SC200 unit. You're going to want to select the desired mode. Now your options are practice, target, and approach. Now we're going to talk more about that later when we talk about the actual functions of the remote control. Next, you're going to use the remote to select the desired club that you're going to use for this session. Now you can actually use the remote to customize the loft of the club if desired. Next, you're gonna position the unit in line with your swing arc. Now this should be roughly 3 feet behind the golf ball or the swing zone. It should also be facing the direction that the golf ball is going to fly. Once you've completed that, you are now ready to play. Now that we have the SC200 unit in place and ready to go, let's talk about some of the functions on the remote control. The first button we want to talk about is the mode button, which is located on the top left-hand corner of the remote control. Now, when you press the mode button, you can alternate in between three different settings. The first setting is the practice setting. This displays immediate feedback on the shot that you've just hit. Next up is the target setting. Now, in the target setting, you can actually set the target distance that you'd like to practice hitting the golf ball.
133 yards.
You can move the distances or change the distances simply on the remote control by pressing the plus or the minus button. You can also change the distance on the actual unit by hitting the up arrow or the down arrow. The third option is the approach setting. Now in the approach setting, the SC200 will randomly select different distances or targets for you to hit.
77 yards.
It will also provide information whether or not you were able to hit that target. Next up is the stats button. By pressing the stats button, it will display the average stat for each club that you've hit. Information that will be provided is shot distance, swing speed, ball speed, and smash factor. The sleep button. By pressing the sleep button, it powers down the device to save energy and prolong the life of your battery. The total carry button. By pressing the total or carry button, you can measure your total distance or just the carry distance. The loft angle button. By pressing the loft angle button, you can customize the loft angle of each one of your golf clubs. The volume button. The volume button allows you to change the voice output from 1 to 5.
200, 45 yards. 2, 3, 4, 5.
The club buttons. The remote control has the golf club numbers where you can switch to the ones you're using or like to use. I are for your irons, driver, wood, utility, and three wedges. Let's talk about the actual buttons on the SC200 itself. Now there's four main buttons plus the on-off switch. Now the on-off switch, as we've talked about already, is located in the top right-hand corner. When I flip it down, when the switch is down, the unit is off. When I flip the switch up, the unit comes on. Also, on the left-hand side of the unit, there's a mode button. Now, when I press the mode button, I can alternate in between the practice setting, target setting, and the approach setting. Now, if you need a reminder on those, we also covered that when we talked about all the different functions of the remote control. Just below the mode button is the club stats button. What this allows you to do is change the club that you're hitting and also adjust your lofts. Located on the right-hand side of the unit is the minus and plus button. By holding down the minus button, you can change the units from yards to meters and also miles per hour to kilometers per hour. One of the great things about the SC200 unit is the ability to track your stats over a long period of time. Now, eventually though, you're gonna wanna reset those stats. Let's talk about how we're gonna do that. First, you're gonna take your remote control and hit the stats function button. On the actual device, the SC200, press and hold the C button, which is located on the left-hand side of the unit. When you do this, all stats will be cleared from the device. Now, let's talk about the barometric function feature. We all know that the wonderful game of golf is played all over the globe, and that being the case, there are lots of different changes in the environment where the SC200 is being used. And that's why we have what we call the barometric function feature. Now what that does and what that means to you as a golfer is the unit itself senses temperature and changes in the atmosphere. So what we can do is give you better, more accurate information. So no matter where you're using the unit, high elevation, low elevation, lots of humidity, no humidity, you can know with guarantee that you're getting the most accurate information possible. Now it's time for us to talk about and define some of the things, some of the numbers, some of the words that you're gonna see when using your SC200. I wanna take a few moments and talk about three golf terms that you hear a lot of and also you're gonna see on your SC200 unit. Now the first one is swing speed. Swing speed is simply the miles per hour that the club head is traveling at the moment of impact. Next up, ball speed. Ball speed is very similar to club head speed. It's the miles per hour that the golf ball is traveling just after impact. Last but not least is what we call smash factor. Now, smash factor is a calculation between the club head speed and the ball speed. Basically, what it does is it tells us how efficient are we at transferring energy from the golf club into the golf ball. Now the gold standard for a smash factor with the driver is 1.5. So when you see that number on there, you kind of get an idea of really what you're looking at. Now when you're hitting your irons, you're not going to see a smash factor even remotely close to 1.5. But when you're hitting that driver, 1.5 is the gold standard for the smash factor. Last but not least, it's time for us to talk about how to replace the battery on the remote control. When it comes time to replace the battery on your remote control, there's a couple things that I want you to remember. Now, first of all, the battery is located on the back side of the remote control. Now, you're gonna wanna use a small object to press and hold the door release button. A paper clip seems to work best. While pressing the door release button, softly slide the lid forward to expose the battery. Remove the old battery and place the new one in there. Make sure that the plus sign is facing you or looking out. Next, softly replace the lid and the remote control is ready to go. All right, my fellow golfers, we've reached the end of our journey and hopefully in our time together here, we've answered some of the main questions that you have on how to get the most out of your SC200 unit. Because now, in your hands, you have the ability to get better information, more accurate information on your golf game. And what's that gonna do? Well, it's gonna help you understand what you're doing. It's probably gonna help you practice a little bit better. And most importantly, for us here at Swing Caddy, it's gonna hopefully help you enjoy this wonderful game of golf just a little bit more.